then if we change the strategy, because clearly, there's a saying, if you keep doing the same action and expect different results, right? There's an exact quote, but in effect, it's a lack of wisdom. So since it's considered a military operation, and then the Philippines uses a military vessel to resupply, and China behaves in the way that it's still water cannons, a military vessel, and it still then actually grazes towards a military vessel, because what happened was it actually hit one of the local boats, right? It hit one of the civilian boats. Am I correct?
Yes, Ms. Karen,
With
but
General
quite.
Browner in the boat. So if China behaves in that same manner, in the same provocative manner, then it would activate the Mutual Defense Treaty, and China wouldn't want that.
But Ms. Karen, that's the other risk that we're going to take. Are we really
Is
willing
that
to
the
go that
risk you're
far?
taking, or that's a risk China is taking? You see, that's a difference there. If you get the point, is that a
Yes,
risk
Ms.
we
Karen.
are taking, or that's a risk China is taking? Because to
I
activate
think
the Mutual Defense Treaty would be a risk on their part, not ours, right?
I think that is a risk that we're going to take, not just for China. This is the main reason why the president has always been mentioning for the Philippine Coast Guard vessels to maintain our temper, not to escalate the tension, not to be provoked, and not to do anything stupid that would really allow us to go that far with,
Yes,
triggering
but
the
that's what
Mutual
I'm
Defense Treaty.
saying. No, the Philippine Coast Guard is doing an excellent job. The question is, how do you change China's behavior in the sea? Because
Ms.
you are
Karen,
doing an
since,
excellent job, right? You're
yes.
doing an excellent job. The Philippine Coast Guard has water cannons too, but you don't respond in the same manner. So the key now is, how do you make China respond differently at sea? So,
Ms. Karen, since we started the Transparency Initiative and since we have started exposing all this aggressive behavior of China, we know for a fact that there are already reputational costs that the Chinese has, at some point modified their behavior. But I think the one thing that is missing as we try to analyze how China responded every time the resupply mission is that we say that nothing's changing. But definitely it's not true. China has, that's the only thing that they can do right now. They can do water cannon, they can do deployment of Chinese maritime militia, they can do dangerous maneuver. That has always been their only step that they have been doing in a union. But at the end of it, we're still succeeding in doing our resupply mission. I wouldn't say
yeah,
that
but doing the
that.
resupply mission, Commodore, is very short-sighted on your end. I mean, don't get me wrong. Don't take offense here, but the resupply mission, that you are able to do it, is a very short-sighted way to look at it. At the end of the day, China has reclaimed so many islands within the West Philippine Sea. They have succeeded through the years, right? From corals, they have literally built military structures. There's a tarmac in several island, in several areas. I mean, in other words, China is patient. They're in for the long game. So ang tanong ko sa iyo, Commodore, nag-budget ang Senado ng 100 million to rebuild Ayungin Shoal, right? One day, BRP Sierra Madre, masisira po yan. Let's face it, one day, mahuhulog, maaagnas ang barkong yan. So before mangyari yon, there has to be some rebuilding in that area, in BRP Sierra Madre and in Ayungin Shoal. If just to resupply, you are faced with water cannons, how are you envisioning the rebuilding? You'd have to bring in materials. You'd have to
Ms.
bring
Karen,
in
yes,
worker.
Ms. Karen, I wouldn't discuss in further details whether the construction or whatever that is being done in BRP Sierra Madre. But I would like to respond with what you said, that what we are doing is with a short-sighted plan. You know,
No,
as what you
it's
said,
not that. I'm not trying.
the Chinese government change the status quo, you know, through patience. They did it, you know, we have lost Miss Chifri. They have occupied Bajo de Masinloc. They did reclaim some parts of West Philippine Sea without firing a single shot. That is something that we have to internalize. That the operation, the strategic plan that we need to have in the West Philippine Sea is not going to that threshold of armed conflict. It's not going to that threshold of triggering the mutual defense treaty. This will take patience, but definitely this is, you know, the risk that the president is taking. We don't need to provoke anybody. We don't need to escalate the tension. What we need to do is to maintain the status quo. It's peaceful, and yet we're still doing the resupply. Whether we are successful in bringing those supplies that are needed to maintain our vessel, I think we're good with that. And that is for the Philippine Coast Guard to perform, to make sure that the tension will not go up. So I take offense when you said that this is a short-sighted plan. No. This is a long-term goal, Ms. Carr.
No. Don't get me wrong, Commodore. I don't mean for you to take offense, but the resupply mission in the long battle compared to the long battle would be short-sighted, because a resupply mission is a resupply mission. But the long battle is this. Are you telling us that 10 years from now, 20 years from now, the Filipino people are supposed to take the fact that China is blasting water on the resupply missions? Are you saying we're supposed to take this as long as it's successful?
What I'm saying, Ms. Karen, is that we're not going to be provoked. We're not going to be deterred. And that is something that we are willing to take so that we can still enjoy this kind of status quo, that it's just us doing all this funding. It's just us accepting all this, whatever harassment that they can throw at us, but not triggering the mutual defense treaty or even, you know, going that far of having an armed conflict.
But then, Commodore, it's not the Philippines that will trigger the mutual defense treaty. I think it is China's behavior that can trigger it. It's not you. It's not us, because we're not doing anything. Let me cite you research from last year, which you're familiar with. Last year, this year alone, 2023, there have been 5 major instances of what they call a gray attack zone, right, that China has taken that can't trigger the treaty, but it's a form of aggressive harassment. One, February, your team had to endure the laser, the use of laser lights from China. Was it the Philippine Coast Guard, or are we talking about the Navy?
Yes, Ms. Karen. We're the one who experienced the military-grade laser last February.
Okay. And then in March and December, this is a Washington Post report, China swarmed the ocean. They sent a combination of Coast Guard, Navy, militia, right? And they're fishing actually in the area. August, China deployed a water cannon in August. You already stood by that. September, that's when you, which is bravo to the Philippine Coast Guard, cut the floating barriers, correct? December, China uses water cannons again. So this is just 5 of big instances in the West Philippine Sea. Ang tanong ko sa iyo, naniniwala nga ako na sinasabi niyo, titiisin natin, gagawin natin. So are you saying that for 5 years, put it to that long haul, we'd have to endure the water cannon from China vessels, that the resupply missions will be this difficult?
Ms. Karen, I think ang nawawala dito sa assessment na to is that every time that the Chinese are doing that, the international community that supports us since 2016 after the arbitral ruling was decided, pataas ng pataas. I think this is something na kailangan nating isama, no? Whenever we look at what is happening in the West Philippine Sea. We know for a fact na with the number of countries na nag-criticize, nag-condemn, every time na ginagawa ng China to, we don't need to say na ito, wala naman siguro impact sa kanila ito. We're just going to you know, think of other plans. Kasi alam natin, of course, the Department of Foreign Affairs knows, the National Task Force West Philippine Sea knows, na ang ginagawa natin na to, as we expose them and as we take on the bullying of China, meron talagang nangyayari. But of course, this is something na hindi pa natin talaga maidetalye. No, this is something na hindi pa natin masasabi talaga. And there are a lot of reasons why we cannot tell to the public and enumerate all those fasted things. But definitely, Ms. Karen, our approach just now, right now, has been very effective. This is actually the reason why the Chinese government is now intensifying the number of China Coast Guard. And secondly, siguro mali rin, Ms. Karen, na sabihin na tumataas nga ang tension eh, kasi nga ganito ganyan. Well, since the previous administration naman, whatever is happening in Ayungi now and also in Bahaw de Masinloc now has been happening before. Ito pa ulit-ulit kong sinasabi. Kung ano man nangyari noon, saka ngayon, nangyayari naman talaga to eh. Ngayon lang natin, the reason why we are talking about this, it's because we choose to publicize it.
No, which is a good thing. But that's the point. So now you agree to my point. Yung nangyayari ngayon, nangyayari noon pa. So gaano katagal nga magtitiis tayo hanggang para huminto ito? Yan po ang tanong ko. So President Marcos Jr. is doing the right thing. I think we all agree on that, right? The question now is, should there be a change of strategy? Kasi nga, kayo mismo nagsabi. Una, by publicizing it, that's good. The Philippine Coast Guard did the right thing. Number two, now the country knows the heroism of the Philippine Coast Guard. Now the country knows how difficult it is, right? That what the Philippine Coast Guard is doing. Number four, now the country knows that there's more emotional investment with the West Philippine Sea. That clearly this president is taking a stronger and firmer stand. But what I'm asking is in terms of strategy. How can we make China change its behavior, not us?
In terms of strategy, Ms. Karen, I don't want to explain further the strategy. But as what I said, no, ang ginagawa natin ngayong strategy encountering China in the West Philippine Sea has been very effective. It's not just limited to what the public knows and how the public appreciates the Coast Guard's decision for transparency. Ang nawawala nga, ulitin ko ulit, Ms. Karen, no? You reached the point of highlighting that there are more countries now standing behind the Philippines in going against the Chinese aggression in the West Philippine Sea. That is the most important part, Ms. Karen. It's the international community now supporting our efforts in the West Philippine Sea to counter People's Republic of China.
Okay.
And that is something that we cannot measure yet, and I cannot explain to you any further, but that's the most important thing that we, what we have been doing now.
But you did say something that's very important in this interview. You did say that if we resupply using military ships, you believe, you said that earlier, that China will not water cannon our military ships, correct?
No, Ms. Karen, what I said is that if we're going to deploy a military warship in doing the resupply mission, they're also going to change their deployment plan. We can expect them to justify their decision to deploy their PLA Navy vessels as well.
But do you believe their PLA Navy vessels will water cannon our military ships?
I don't believe that they have water cannon in the first place for the warships, but definitely there is one certain thing that I know. The tension there, once you start deploying warships, whether for the Philippine Navy or the PLA Navy vessel, that will be more tense, more escalating, and that is a kind of standoff that we can never really imagine, and we never really want to have another Scarborough Shoal standoff that happened in 2012.
But don't you think if there's a standoff this time, the Philippines would be at an advantage because there's already the arbitral ruling And as you said, more countries are already speaking out and condemning China's actions. Because if you're playing a game of chess, you'd also know when to eat the queen or attack, right?
In the first place, why would you play that kind of game with China?
But that's strategy. That's what China's doing.
That's the point. They are also waiting for us to justify that they can bring in their warship. If you're going to use your warship in the West Philippine Sea, then there's no reason for China to deploy theirs as well. And if you're going to meet them head on 1:1 with the number of warships that they have, with the number of submarines, with the fighter jets that they can deploy, can we really, you know, have that kind of game with the People's Republic of China?
All right. Well, on that note, let me just leave and say that bravo to the Philippine Coast Guard. I want that clear today. So thank you for being on the show, Commodore, and the good work that you and all your men and women do. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Karen. It's always a pleasure to be here.
All right. Have a safe trip, sir.
Thank you.